Back in 1975, Alder Hope was developing rapidly, and we needed extra facilities for our growing Sunday school. However, the organ also needed urgent repairs. The bell cot was unsafe, and there was dry rot and death watch beetle infesting the church floor and timbers. So this put the hopes of financing a hall beyond our reach. Then in 1986, with the church repairs completed, enough money became available to purchase an old caravan, which we sited in the vicarage garden for the use by the Sunday school. But this was still only a temporary measure, and our byword for the future became Beyond the Caravan. In January 1989, quite by chance, an advertisement was seen in a local paper describing a wooden building for sale in Somerset. A rapid timetable then began. It was viewed by the vicar and church wardens in that same month. The parochial church council agreed the purchase in February. It was dismantled screw by screw and transported back to Alder Hope in March. Final planning permission was granted in April. Loans were obtained from individuals and the Salisbury Diocesan Board of Finance, and work began. We had embarked on a mission of faith. Within 4 months, the site was ready for the building framework. Volunteers from within the community freely offered their knowledge, skills, and labour. For the next 18 months, the project became a major priority. Weekends and evenings ceased to exist. Our progress was blessed with great fellowship, and every phase was recorded through a large collection of photographs. Some 35 people worked for over 6,000 hours, and a final result was beyond all our expectations. The hall continues to be a tremendous asset for every facet of our church work today. It is thanks to those who carried the project to completion and all those who have continued the careful maintenance of the building that it is in such excellent condition today. I do hope you enjoy this collection of photos and video footage. The hymns which accompany them are those used at the festival service of dedication 20 years ago.
Oh, peace to this house from the Holy Spirit, the Comforter.
Amen.
Peace to this house from God, the Holy Trinity.
Amen.
Listen, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come into that house. I will eat with those who are there, and they shall eat with me. Come, Lord Jesus, be our guest. Stay with us, for the day is ending. Bring to our house your poverty.
For then we shall be rich.
Bring to our house your pain.
That sharing we may also share your joy.
Bring to our house your understanding of us.
That we may be free to learn more of you.
Bring to our house all those who hurry or hobble behind you.
That we may meet you as the Saviour of all.
With friend, with stranger, with neighbour and the well-known ones, be among us this night.
Lord, our hearts we open, and the doors of our hearts we leave it ajar.
In the name of God, the Holy, Blessed and Undivided Trinity, and in honour of his holy apostles and James, we dedicate this hall, consecrating it to the work of the Kingdom of Heaven within the life of earth. As its walls surround those who enter, so may the Spirit of God and his love bind them together in mutual trust and fellowship and common endeavor for good. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest upon them, on this hall, and on each one of us, this day and forevermore.
Amen.
God is at work in us, his purpose to perform, building a kingdom of power, not in words. Where things impossible, by faith shall be made possible. Let's give the glory to him now. Rejoice, rejoice, Christ is singing the hope of glory in our hearts. He lifts his breath and singing arise.
All projects, all on the... Okay,
just do it yourself.
Okay.
Exactly 68 years, I think, 1922, try your mathematics, the chancel and the vestry was dedicated on St. James's Day, built by members of local families. And it is good to know there are those here tonight who have helped to build this hall and who come from some of those families. Beyond the caravan was the phrase Stephen used for many months whilst we explored various options for replacing the accommodation used by the Sunday school. The hall we see now is certainly beyond our expectations. And to all of you who have worked so hard, thank you many times over. We could not have embarked on this venture without considerable financial and material help being given to us by many local firms and individuals. To you, we are indebted. However, we are acutely aware that this building will generate its own running costs, which together with our church expenses and commitment to the diocese is a formidable expense account. Fitting out will need consideration. The red chairs you see in the tables are hired from the village hall. We do have some chairs, but they're waiting to be refurbished. How much we shall need your continuing prayers, your participation in our church life, and when possible, your pounds and your pennies. A personal thank you to all that prepared delicious things for us to eat this evening. To Gwen Wright for the gift of a celebration cake, and to Angela Hibbard for the making of it. Mrs. Baker has agreed to cut the first slice for us, and in a short while, the rural dean will be doing some gardening. In fact, he's going to plant a tree. Happily, during an interregnum, and I hesitate to say this, Bishop John, but the church wardens feel free to do a little as they like.
That time too.
However, where the building of this hall has been concerned, at all times we have taken our instructions from the prime mover, organiser and builder-in-chief John Cox. Constant enthusiasm, tenacity and single-mindedness, we might well have faltered along the way. Please, John.
Yes,
Jean.
Come here. You didn't come here to
embarrass me.
Come here. So I came into the
drink room. On behalf of those who have worked with him, it is our hope.
I don't play a piano.
It is our hope that Dawn will benefit from this gift as well. And that you will both be reminded at times of the labour of love that went into the building of this hall, which we can truly call yours as much as we call ours. So we want to say that. Now you may say something.
You've left.
That's okay.
Not wrong. Maybe sure we won't be together.
Well, I did promise that I wouldn't speak any longer than the bishop preached. So I should have to be quick. Seriously, I should say a personal thank you to all my workforce later on for that. It's a total surprise, I can assure you. But I do need one after this project. And they must know that. But I've just got one or two notes down here because I really feel I would like to make a personal thank you to various people, various organisations over the 18 months that we have worked together. And when I agreed to be project manager for whatever other term you like to call it, I certainly, like our reading this evening, needed faith. Because I agreed when the PCC asked me if I would, with no money, no labour force, and no materials. We just had a building that we bought. And to that, we set to and put in plans for. And whilst the plans were going through in the 6 weeks or so it took for them to go through, and when they finally were passed and we had to go ahead, we had money. Our faith and our prayers were answered. We had donations interest-free loans, and we also had people organizing events, not only then, but on through the project, to raise funds for this project of ours. And to those people, I say a very sincere thank you, because without you, we couldn't have done what we have done here. No money, we couldn't have carried on. But we haven't been held up for anything at all. We're broke now, I might add, but we haven't been held up for anything at all during the project, and that is, I think, fantastic for you people out there, wherever you are, that kept the money flowing for us. We didn't only have donations of money, though. I contacted several companies around the district, and majority of them agreed to give us a helping hand. So we had donations in materials.
Will you cut the cake?
It's a beautiful cake. I don't want to cut it, but I think we should all shut our eyes and wish. Are you ready, everybody?
Yes.
Right.
That's lovely. Thank you.
And can I just say, on behalf of the dancers, we're all so proud of you and what you've done. And if all our communities and churches had this sort of spirit, I won't say the kingdom of God would instantly appear, but we're a lot nearer than it is now. Thank you very much indeed.
He has blessed this project from beginning to end with weather, with things being put right when it's been put in his hands, and many, many times through the last 18 months I've left it to the Lord to sort out a problem which perhaps the majority of workforce thought that I've done, but I haven't. I thank him for my health, for my ability to be able to do what I've done within this project. And I'd like to finish by saying that on our dedication plaque, we say, built to the glory of God. I say, to God be the glory. Amen.